Say a construction project in the Northeast Heights is killing their bottom line. If you've been near the corner of Wyoming and San Antonio, you may have run into a bottleneck at the intersection. Action 7 News reporter Will Carr spoke to one business owner who says the businesses on that corner can't take much more.
It's not just me, it's everybody.
J.J. Jager, the owner of J.J.'s Premier Tire and Service, says the construction project at the corner of San Antonio and Wyoming has forced nearby businesses' profits to come to a screeching halt.
It's frustrating for everybody. It's customers, the businesses. A lot of people have been down quite a bit because of it. And I mean, I hear on the radio every day, avoid San Antonio and Wyoming.
Jager says his business is down 30% to 35%. Others as much as 50%.
They say this is killing their business. What would you say to them?
We're encouraging people to continue to, you know, visit their local businesses and help their economies and stuff.
Mark Motzko with the city says this is the second phase of a project that is adding another travel lane and bike lane to Wyoming.
We want to show you just exactly how long that people are sitting in traffic out here. So I'm actually on San Antonio. It's 520 right now, just about rush hour traffic.
And it didn't take long before we ran into a line of backed up traffic.
So right now it's 525. We're still just kind of inching along. Still haven't even gotten all the way up to Wyoming.
In all, it took us 8 minutes to get through the intersection. It may not sound like much, but to Jager, it's an eternity.
I mean, every day you're losing. Every day you're losing not just your regular customers, but the traffic that drives by.
We would just encourage drivers to be patient with us, encourage business owners to be patient with us. Again, 3 weeks, we'll be out of there.
Northeast Albuquerque, Will Carr, KOAT Action 7 News.
Business owners say the project should have been planned better. The city says it's placed blue signs to show the businesses are still open, saying the entire project will last until the end of the year.